We got to do mobility first because that's the way we got here. We didn't show up doing side planks in the crib. We had mobility. And with that mobility, we tried to move. Visual stimulus, auditory stimulus, we tried to move. First thing you could do, move your head around. Second thing you could do, look over here and, hey, my shoulder moved. You start rolling. You're exploring mobility. Put your hands in your mouth. Put your feet in your mouth. Next thing you know, I can actually get to point A to point B quicker if I get up and just do this, dragging my legs behind me. Shoulder's the first weight-bearing joint in the body, not the hip. Then I get my legs up under me. I can move faster. Now the fuzzball on the other side of the room will be in my mouth quicker, and I need that in my mouth. Before you know it, they're what? Cruising around. They're holding on to stuff, and they get all cocky, like go to take a step. Whap! All right. There's always a coffee table with a corner right there. I mean, one in every three kids has the scar. Kids earn their stability. If they take a step without it, what does life do to them? Puts them right back down. Unless you hand them a Johnny Jump Up or one of those little wheel things, and you let your kid walk before they deserve to walk. And what do? Why do they got pronated feet? Because you let them walk before they had enough hip strength to stand up. So what are they supposed to do? Collapse their arch and do that. Anybody got little ones at home? So you're out in public, you see them trying to stand up. It's better if you kick them back down. Keep them crawling, multifidus, TA, all right? Now, other people are going to look at you funny when you kick kids. It's my kid and I'm a professional, we're working on. Don't you get it? Get down there. Life is set up to challenge us developmentally. And a child isn't allowed to take a step unless they got stability.